Hi, I'm Lee Brukeen with Louisiana Football TV Magazine. Be sure to watch our show every Tuesday night live at 6:30 and catch your replays at 10:30 at night. We've got the top recruits in the state every week, high school coaches, former pro players, and current pro players. Be sure to watch Louisiana Football TV Magazine on Cox 4. I'm Lee Brukeen with Louisiana Football TV Magazine. There's a lot to talk about. We have a national championship game close to a month from today. We have the high school championships in the Superdome this weekend. We have Cat Haven on tonight. Yeah, we're going to try and adopt as many cats as possible, do a good duty to in Baton Rouge to save these little cats' lives. We've got Dr. Alan Schroeder from the Bone and Joint Clinic. I've got Coach Tommy Minton from Patterson, the head coach, two of his top recruits. And also Mickey McCarty's calling in from Neville High School in Monroe. Mickey, his team's in the Superdome in 4A, playing for the state championship. We'll be back. We'll take your calls. We'll be back in just a moment.
A sports injury can put you out of action, but your game's not over because you drafted the right team. At the Bone and Joint Clinic, you're treated by experts in sports medicine, experienced therapists and staff, and the latest equipment and services in a comfortable environment where you're treated like family, because we want to see you suit up again. The Bone and Joint Clinic.
Hi, I'm Joe Martin, president of ITI Technical College. And for over 35 years, ITI has been a leader in technical education here in Baton Rouge.
ITI's medical division offers hands-on training in three new medical programs: medical billing and coding, medical management, and medical assistant. ITI offers flexible class schedules, and financial aid is available.
So let ITI help you discover a better life. Call now or go online. It's that simple.
ITI for a better life.
At Peak Performance Physical Therapy, we treat everyone from long drivers to unlucky drivers. Now with seven locations to serve you. If your doctor recommends physical therapy, ask for Peak Performance by name. The physical therapy choice of golfers, injured drivers, and everyone in between.
If you're looking for the gear you need in the colors you bleed, then make your first stop Co-op. Much more than just a bookstore. Co-op has the largest selection of LSU merchandise for the whole family, including tailgating supplies, LSU clothing and accessories, great gifts, and a whole lot more. Stop in or order online for the best prices on art supplies, school supplies, and textbooks. The Co-op Bookstore, where you'll always find the gear you need in the colors you bleed.
As a designer here at Bassett, I've helped all kinds of people find the custom furniture they really want. Beautiful fabrics and leathers? Got them. A choice of finishes? Sure. The best color combos? No problem. Whatever you're looking for, I can help you find it, and we'll have it ready in 30 days. Custom furniture from Bassett. It's a great way to make your home your own.
Appreciate the job and support that Papa John's Pizza, one of our great sponsors, feeds our staff, all our guests. Be sure to support them. Support Papa John's. They have several locations in Baton Rouge. They do a great job. I appreciate it. Michelle Rabelais does a great job, the marketing director for Papa John's here in Baton Rouge. Great pizza, and appreciate their support. We're going to go ahead and I want to introduce our first guest, Dr. Alan Schroeder, a orthopedic surgeon from the Bone and Joint Clinic, one of our sponsors, one of our first sponsors very loyal sponsor. The company's been with us from just about day one that we've been on the air as a show. So close to 7 years. The Bone and Joint's been supportive of all the high schools in Baton Rouge and then some all over the state of Louisiana. But this is the first appearance. Dr. Alan Schroeder, you're the first doctor to come on our show from the Bone and Joint Clinic. We're glad to have
you. Thanks for having me here, Lee. I appreciate it.
It's always hard to talk about what you're going to talk about. There's so many things to talk about with injuries. You know, knee, shoulder injuries, back injuries, hand injuries. But you see it all every day.
We do. We see all types of injuries from athletes of all different sports. Football seems to be one of the more major sports we see a lot of different injuries from.
And you played sports.
Yes,
you
sir.
Were a weight. You told me you were a competitive weightlifter in high school.
I had to do all the sports that went by weight class. I'm right. Kind of a small fella.
But you would lose weight and gain weight, right, to get in your
right.
weight class,
fit
right?
In different classes.
I, you know, admire that. I mean, you that takes a lot of control of what you eat that week, right?
Yeah, it takes a lot of discipline.
Tell everybody about, I know there's one important part of Bone and Joint Clinic that a lot of people really might not know, but you have a full-time sports PT on staff
right.
At the Bone and Joint Clinic.
At the Bone and Joint Clinic, someone who works with me is a full-time athletic trainer who's available to help triage different injuries. It's very important for coaches, especially schools that don't have their own athletic trainers. He's available to give those coaches some guidance as to who needs to be seen or who they can take care of with simple treatment themselves.
And Dr. Schroeder, tell everybody, what's the day in a life of a surgeon right now? I mean, you start at what time in the morning, and what time do you end every day, right? Is it football coaching hours, basically, after 5 o'clock?
Maybe not quite as bad as a football coach, but it's pretty early. We typically get going about 7 in the morning, and usually I make it home somewhere around 7 or 7:30 at night.
Dedication, love. You have to love what you're doing.
I do.
Tell everybody, I mean, there's 12 doctors. Orthopedic surgeons at the Bone and Joint Clinic, and tell everybody where the Bone and Joint Clinic is in Baton Rouge if they want to go or make a phone call
sure.
to the clinic.
The Bone and Joint Clinic is on Hennessy Boulevard, which is near Our Lady of the Lake and Baton Rouge General Hospital, centrally located in the city, and our own orthopedic complex, which is a three-story building that has the clinic, as well as MRI and a surgery center and a therapy center, all in the same location.
And it's a great facility. I've been there several times to meet with your administrator, Mark LeVere. I want to give him some props tonight. He does a great job for the Bone and Joint Clinic. And I want to go ahead and pick one angle. Everybody wants to talk about knees. Talk about the knee injuries that you've seen, Dr. Schroeder, this year. Compared to years past, but there seems to be more and more knee injuries in athletics, not just football, because I know
right.
that y'all treat all sports.
We do. Athletes are basically getting bigger, stronger, and faster, which leads to higher impact collisions, and then people want to be active longer, so even in other age brackets past the high school and college athletes, people are playing longer, and they get a little hurt here and there, and we help them get back playing.
I remember I was talking to you off the air about I'm on a competitive league full court basketball. Still want to play a couple hours 2 days a week. We play to 15 and to 20 points a game by one. Don't ignore pain, as you told me, because I had a question for you. I was like, when do you know you're hurting? Well, don't ignore, you told me, that constant pain, because something would be wrong.
Right.
Something's
right.
wrong with your body.
Most things you can ice and take a up to about a week worth of ibuprofen, and if things aren't calming down with that and some activity modification, it might be time to get checked out.
Anything you want to talk about tonight as far as injuries besides knee? I know that you do shoulder, you do hand numbness, you do just about everything.
Right. I do sports medicine, which sort of implies mostly joints. We see all different types of sprains, strains, fractures, and chronic repetitive injury as well.
Now, I want you to mention this, but you are one of the few doctors in Baton Rouge. Tell them that you have.
One of the few doctors that's done a fellowship, which is an extra year in orthopedic sports medicine. and also achieved a subspecialty board certification in orthopedic sports medicine.
And you have a degree in a couple of more areas.
So I got a few other degrees. I got a degree in health management, and also my undergraduate degrees in biomedical engineering.
Well, how long were you in college? How long?
I probably did about 12 years of school after high school.
Wow, amazing. Again, bone and joint clinic. If you're a parent watching, or a coach, or if you're not even an athlete, if you need someone to go to, Bone and Joint is a great place, the Bone and Joint Clinic, to go see them and set up an appointment and give them a number, doctor, that they can call to the Bone and Joint Clinic.
Our main clinic number is 766-0050.
And I want to, you don't ever leave empty-handed on my show. We have a Superior Grill gift certificate. Okay, I hope you like Mexican food. It's the best in Baton Rouge. And I have a t-shirt for you from our company. Thank you.
All right.
Appreciate you being on the show tonight. Thanks for the support.
Thanks a lot, Lee.
Thank you. And we'll be back with Wendy Decker with Cat Haven. We're going to promote their adoptions for Christmas, which is coming up this Sunday, for kitty cats. We'll be back in just a moment.
Can buying furniture really be fun? Sure. Come into Bassett and an in-store designer like me will be happy to help. Just tell me a little about yourself and what you're looking for, and then I'll give you a bunch of great ideas. And our design help is free. Who could say no to that? Come into Bassett and discover the easy, affordable way to make a beautiful home.
Farm agents Brian Moe and Joan Meir in Baton Rouge are there for you. Call today.
Louisiana Office Supply is the largest stocking office product store in the South, with a new 23,000 square foot showroom. For over 72 years, Louisiana Office Supply has met the demand for quality office products, competitively priced with an extensive selection and knowledgeable staff. From office furniture to Post-it notes, there are supplies for every part of your office. Louisiana Office Supply, generation after generation. Exceptional service since 1936.
Arrive to the game in style in a new or certified Peretti family vehicle.
Jaguar, with timeless elegance, is the sportiest, sexiest luxury automobile on the road. Land Rover is rough enough for all your hunting needs, yet refined enough to deserve valet parking. Mazda will connect you with your inner driver at a whole new level of intensity.
Remember, it's not whether you win or lose, it's how you get to the game. Peretti, Jaguar, Land Rover, Mazda, Baton Rouge, New Orleans.
Have you made the right call?
I made the right call.
It's easy to do. Just touch the tones.
I made the right call.
If you want to talk to the pros, you've got to make the right call.
I made the right call.
It's not that kind of call. I'm talking about the professionals at Gage Telephone. From excellent products like Toshiba to great service after the sale, make the right call. Gage Telephone, 753-4243.
A sports injury can put you out of action. But your game's not over, because you drafted the right team. At the Bone and Joint Clinic, you're treated by experts in sports medicine, experienced therapists and staff, and the latest equipment and services, in a comfortable environment where you're treated like family. Because we want to see you suit up again. The Bone and Joint Clinic.
Believe it. Come on. We're back with Louisiana Football TV Magazine. Be sure to check out our website to get the magazine. The preview magazine is still out. If you didn't get the magazine earlier this year, that's the website, the store that you can go to order it. Or Barnes & Noble at those locations in the state. But I'm about to introduce to you Wendy Decker with Cat Haven in Baton Rouge, and let her explain what she does. You know, first of all, I want to mention that I wanted to do something for the community, and I chose to promote Cat Haven as to help save lives of these little kitty cats. And I'll let her explain how they get the cats, and I'll tell a story about how I have a cat now. You know, I didn't want a cat, but it involved a football game. And Wendy has a cat on set. We've never had an animal on our show, but she has a kitten, and that kitten's name is T-Bob, which they named after the LSU football T-Bob Hebert. And I believe this cat is 8 to 10 weeks old?
Yeah, about 10 weeks old. Little T-Bob is a boy. He'll probably be ready for adoption next week because we need to have him medically ready for adoption, get him neutered and all. And we have a Cat Haven Adoption Center. It's on North Harrells Ferry Road. And we have about 60 to 80 kitties there probably. We're open every day from noon until 6, except on Sundays. And we're doing a lot of adoptions right now, cats and kittens going home for Christmas, and we hope to do a whole lot more. We're having our open house on Sunday, the 11th.
Yeah, I was going to mention, I'm glad you got that out, but what, tell everybody how many cats on the average are adopted every week, that lives that you save, mm-hmm. cats' lives that are not euthanized at the mm-hmm. shelters.
It varies, yeah. Last week we had a tremendous week. We adopted out 17 kitties. Okay. Usually it's more on the order of about 5, so we were really excited about last week. And we get kitties mm-hmm. like T-Bob here. He traveled in somebody's car engine to their home, and they found him when they got home and could not keep him. So we took him in, and we'll get him ready to be safe in a new home.
That's a miracle cat
mm-hmm.
to survive traveling in the motor
of
a car.
Yes, we hear lots of stories like that.
Now, you told me that you adopted a cat a few weeks ago by the last name of Miles, right, for Les Miles?
Oh, yes. Miles went home with a college professor, and then we've had a Jordan lately, and then
we've
had
Jefferson.
Kiki
Mango.
Yes. So we're capitalizing on all those LSU players'
all the cats.
Names.
Yeah. I want to mention a story. I have a cat. I'm filming a game 5 years ago in Opelousas to go film the game. I'm all serious about this game. I'm there to watch a guy named Brandon Alexander, who's 6'6", about 260. He was a freshman then, but he's now at Texas A&M. And I take a break, and I was getting some cocoa at halftime. It was about 20 degrees. And I went with my film guy. My film guy is... Brett Alello, he's there with me. We're filming the game, and I've never left a high school game in my life filming a game, but this was a different thing. At halftime, I'm trying to get something to eat, and this little kitty cat, this little kitten, is all over my legs, starving, beat up. He's at the concession stands, and all these little girls and moms are picking this cat up. Even the coach's wife was picking the cat up, and nobody wanted this cat, and I'm like, okay, we're picking up. Stop filming. I'm gonna bring this cat home. So many dollars later, got him well. I named the cat Tiger because Opelousas, they're the Tigers. So I got a cat named Tiger now from a football game, and somebody I hope will adopt T-Bob.
Mm-hmm.
And
many
several
more.
many more your cats at Cat Haven. Again, tell everybody one more time how to go to Cat Haven and what number to call.
Okay, our phone number is 636-2680. You can also go to our website, cathaven.org, and we're on North Harrells Ferry, 11130 North Harrells Ferry in Baton Rouge.
Well, good luck to you, and I hope little T-Bob gets a home real soon.
Yes.
and several other kittens, and I'm glad that we can help promote Cat Haven tonight.
Thank you so much for having us.
Okay.
We appreciate you.
We're going to come back. Our next guest is Tommy Minton. Who the head coach of Patterson High School. He's going to be joining us shortly. We'll be back in just a moment.
If you're looking for the gear you need in the colors you bleed, then make your first stop Co-op. Much more than just a bookstore, Co-op has the largest selection of LSU merchandise for the whole family, including tailgating supplies, LSU clothing and accessories, great gifts, and a whole lot more. Stop in or order online for the best prices on art supplies, school supplies, and textbooks. The Co-op Bookstore, where you'll always find the gear you need in the colors you bleed.
Ha ha!
State Farm agents Brian Moe and Joan Meir in Baton Rouge are there for you. Call today.
Hi, I'm Joe Martin, president of ITI Technical College. And for over 35 years, ITI has been a leader in technical education here in Baton Rouge. Our commitment is to help people just like you attain a better life through technical training.
Get hands-on real-life training in one of nine career areas with flexible class schedules, and financial aid is available.
So let ITI help you discover a better life. Call now or go online. It's that simple.
ITI for a better life.
Have you made the right call?
I made the right call.
It's easy to do. Just touch the tones.
I made the right call.
If you want to talk to the pros, you've got to make the right call.
I made the right call.
It's not that kind of call. I'm talking about the professionals at Gage Telephone. From excellent products like Toshiba to great service after the sale, make the right call. Gage Telephone, 753-4243.
At Peak Performance Physical Therapy, we treat everyone from Grand Slam hitters to grandparents. Now with seven locations to serve you. If your doctor recommends physical therapy, ask for Peak Performance by name, the physical therapy choice of baseball players, grandparents, and everyone in between.
This is College Notes. I want to mention that the All-SEC teams came out this week. Brad Wing, I can't believe, was second team by the coaches. Best punter in the United States, best punter since Ray Guy, in my opinion. He's second team on the coach's team, but he's first team AP. What's wrong with that? Another thing, Benny Logan's not first or second team at D-tackle from LSU. Are people watching the same football games that I'm watching? Benny Logan's left off the first and second team. Benny, dominating Alabama game. I'm sure they'll have you preseason All-SEC next year. I also want to mention Spencer Ware. I don't think it's at 100% right now, and I really have a lot of admiration for him for running that football because he got LSU where they are now early against Florida, Oregon, Mississippi State, and Tennessee. A month off, I think, with Spencer 100%, Kenny Hilliard, Ford, and Blue, the offense will start off a little bit better, I believe, against Alabama. I think that's going to be the key. That Spencer Ware gets some time to heal up those bumps and bruises, Coach.
Well, those 4 weeks are critical to any college program for a lot of reasons. The health of your key players that are bumped up and bruised after 13 weeks. And also, it's almost like 4 weeks of spring training for those younger kids, too, extra practice time. The college coaches love that.
Now, I'm going to get to your players later on in the show. You've got Lorenzo Phillips coming on and one of your great receivers who's committed to the University of Houston. But I want to get to Kenny Hilliard. And Tommy Minton's the head football coach at Patterson High School. I've known for, I count it, 21 years now, back when you were at Plaquemine. Already 21 years. But you've had a great run at Patterson. You've had some great players come out of your program. And all these LSU fans tonight, I know, want me to ask you about Kenny Hilliard, your former player at LSU, true freshman. We talked about, and this is for a lot of people I know too, but we talked about it off air that he's not 240 anymore. He's actually lost some weight. And his ability to run and the way he's run with the time, and he's feeling more comfortable. Tell everybody about how proud of you, I guess, of Kenny this early. This is not shocking to you, right? I mean, what he's doing.
Well, no, it's not shocking. I mean, I watched him for 4 years in high school. I felt like he had the ability to step in and play if he was in condition. Kenny missed a lot of summertime this summer. He had a shoulder surgery at the end of spring, and he did not report the August drills in top shape. He was about 242 pounds when he reported. He's about 232 right now. He told me last week he weighed 232 on Thursday after practice. So, and you know, he came in as a freshman, had to get his feet wet, had to learn the system. But I think he's done a good job of showing the coaches by playing fullback early on that, you know, he would do what it takes to get on the field. He just wanted to help the team win. And when his number was called against Auburn, when Spencer was out, he answered the call and did what was needed. And he's gotten more touches every week since.
Well, Coach, I'll watch the Georgia game, obviously the Arkansas game. But anybody that's a true freshman that runs the ball 20 yards in a big game against nine guys in the box, I mean, for him to do that, 5 touchdowns out of 9 in the last 2 weeks is incredible.
I mean, he had years in high school. 3 out of his 4 years in high school, he scored over 30 touchdowns. So he knows where the end zone is, and he's used to 9 men in the box because he saw that for four years in high school. But he's done a great job, and his work ethic is phenomenal at practice. And, you know, Coach Wilson has told me, you know, he advanced up the depth chart early in the season because of his work ethic at practice. And as long as he keeps that and stays focused on what he's got to do, I think he's going to have a great career at LSU.
Coach Minton, I mean, I know they use the 4 backs, and it's working to wear people down. Blue, Spencer Ware, Michael Ford in the option, and then, you know, Kenny with the power and the quickness. Do you think, and this is just I'm asking your opinion, the national championship game's a month away. That's a lot more practices, a lot more time. You think Kenny will maybe have a chance to even get the ball more in the national championship game?
I think they have a method that they've used, and I think he'll get his touches and his and the packages that he's involved in. And they've had success using all 4. I think it keeps fresh legs in the game in the fourth quarter when the defense is wearing down. So, I mean, he's playing in the best program in the country, and he's not questioning anything. He's ready to play when his number's called, and I think he's going to continue that.
And you got 5 backs if you count Terrence McGee.
Exactly.
But, you know, I know this is what happens. People go, oh, they got too many. Spencer Ware, you know, won't be here probably all 4 years. Michael Ford's a redshirt sophomore. I mean, he could go pro after next year. So I don't think you're going to – it's always a revolving door, guys.
You never have too many. There's no such thing as too many. All these guys are getting their touches. They're going to get a chance to go to the NFL. They're going to have fresh legs. They're not going to be beat up by carrying the ball so much during their college career. And all you got to do is go back to the Oregon game. LaMichael James and the second team back for Oregon were both hurt in the third quarter, and they had to resort to a true freshman that fumbled twice.
And didn't have a third back.
Exactly.
And I remember, this reminds me of the days, coaches, when LSU had Hester, and they had a guy named Joseph Adai, and they had a guy named Ollie Broussard. Those were 3 great guys running the ball.
Justin Vincent.
Those were the 4. I mean, so, and I think these 4 are better as a group.
And they won a national championship.
They won a national championship, yeah. Justin Vincent, you can't forget what he did in Atlanta Dome, that great run that opened up the game to get LSU to the first national championship against Oklahoma under then Nick Saban. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to have more of Coach Tommy Minton. We've got Mickey McCarty that's going to be calling in a couple of segments from Neville High School. And we're going to end the show with the 2 top recruits from Patterson. Coach has others, but we've got 2 of them tonight, and we'll talk to them and also go over all the other top players at Patterson High School. You're watching Louisiana Football TV Magazine. We'll be back in just a minute.
Louisiana Office Supply is the largest stocking office product store in the South with a new 23,000 square foot showroom. For over 72 years, Louisiana Office Supply has met the demand for quality office products competitively priced with an extensive selection and knowledgeable staff. From office furniture to post-it notes, there are supplies for every part of your office. Louisiana Office Supply, generation after generation, exceptional service since 1936.
Have you made the right call?
I made the right call.
It's easy to do. Just touch the tones.
I made the right call.
If you want to talk to the pros, you've got to make the right call.
I made the right call.
It's not that kind of call. I'm talking about the professionals at Gage Telephone. From excellent products like Toshiba to great service after the sale, make the right call. Gage Telephone, 753-4243.
State Farm agents Brian Moe and Joan Meir in Baton Rouge are there for you. Call today.
As a designer here at Bassett, I've helped all kinds of people find the custom furniture they really want. Beautiful fabrics and leathers? Got them. A choice of finishes? Sure. The best color combos? No problem. Whatever you're looking for, I can help you find it, and we'll have it ready in 30 days. Custom Furniture from Bassett. It's a great way to make your home your own.
A sports injury can put you out of action, but your game's not over because you drafted the right team. At the Bone and Joint Clinic, you're treated by experts in sports medicine, experienced therapists and staff, and the latest equipment and services in a comfortable environment where you're treated like family, because we want to see you suit up again. The Bone and Joint Clinic.
Be sure to check out LAFootballMagazine.com, our website, the .com store. You can order the magazine if you're watching this in the state. Or you can go to Barnes & Noble, where they still have issues. If your kid's in the issue, we promote it. Most of the starters at the schools, and I do that. We're already writing the 012 issue right now that'll be out this coming August. Well, I'll start on that as soon as we put the first one out. So we want to go ahead and go to our Recruit of the Week. Sponsored by State Farm.
The Recruit of the Week is brought to you by State Farm agents Joan Meir and Brian Moe.
Here's a big lineman from Ouachita Christian, 1A school. They're in a state title game. He's a tackle. See the takedown? 6'4", 265, committed to ULL of Lafayette, Louisiana of Lafayette. He's a strong kid. He benches about 350. It's a legit 350. Squats a legit 5. He's a 5 flat 40. That's what I like the most. He's a fast kid. 5 flat's fast for somebody 265, 6'4". I think Coach Minton will agree with me, Zach Tarver. We're going to go ahead and go to our phone lines. We have Eddie. Eddie might have a question for Coach Minton or myself. Eddie, glad to have you tonight.
Hey, thanks.
Hey, what's your question?
Yeah, I got a question for Coach. I wanted to ask Coach what he thought about the 3A matchup against St. Charles Catholic in a meet. What his opinion of how that matchup is going to work out this weekend, and what did he think, and maybe what his prediction was.
I'm predicting St. Charles. I mean, I know a lot about them from 2 weeks ago. I think Coach Monica's got a great football team, and he's getting back healthy now. His two backs were out for a while and hurt. He had both of those back playing last week, and I've not seen a meet on film but one time this year. I know Coach Foster's got a great defense. Looking at the scores, I don't think they've allowed but 39 points all year in 13 ball games.
Yeah.
But I think it's a different class team. He's playing Saturday in the Dome, and I know St. Charles defense. I know what they can do up front. And Amit's kind of one-dimensional with the run game, and I think they're going to have a hard time moving the ball. And I'm going to have to go with St. Charles.
All right. Thanks, Coach. Appreciate it.
I'm going to go with St. Charles, too, because Frank Monica, I didn't think he was going to beat your team. You were the only team I picked that didn't win at all. But that is a compliment to you, Coach, though.
Well,
your team. But
it ain't a compliment to me that I'm sitting here right now. I'd rather be working.
Right. But, I know that. I understand that.
Coach Monica does a great job year in and year out. And he runs St. Charles like a college program. And, his teams are always ready to play. He had some classic battles with John Curtis years ago when they were in the district, and they played in district, and they played again for the state championship. His teams are going to always be ready to play. He had a junior-laden team last year. I think he had 17 starters back off a team that lost in the semifinals last year. So
I'm amazed every year by Frank Monica. And, I mean, you know this coach. It's not the size of the players sometimes that give you a win, but they don't average 250. They got that big nose guard, Cochran, on D-tackle. That was 6'3",
big nose
about
guard's a
300
player.
Pounds.
He's about 320, and he's a load. He did a great job of stopping the inside run game for him all year. Every film we had on him, the kid was playing great. And he's got the Smith kid, defensive end 92, is also an excellent
LeJalen,
player.
LeJalen, yeah. And he's not a 250, but he's a quick 220 kid.
Yeah.
And Their receivers and DBs are what's deceptive. They're not huge, but they're tough kids. Yeah. Let's go to Randy. We got Randy on the line. Randy, do you have a question?
Yeah, what do you think about West Monroe and Karen Crow this weekend?
Ooh, sounds like you might be from Karen Crow. But I picked West Monroe to win it all. They're still in it. Karen Crow.
How are you going to stop Karen Crow's rushing attack?
I love Karen Crow's team, though. I think Brent Endes has done a phenomenal job. Their O-line is huge. Their running backs, come on.
I think the Johnson kid, the junior running back, might be the best running back in the state, regardless of class.
Yeah.
I think he's a phenomenal player.
And a quarterback is a linebacker with speed, you know, Jalen.
Yeah. Nixon, yeah.
And the linebackers for Karen Crow is what's really surprised me this year. They got two linebackers that are all, I mean, they're everywhere, and they're not 6'2", 6'1", as you know, and they're great DBs. Their back four are very athletic. Yeah, the big tight end that's a junior, 6'5", about 230. I think the key to this game is Karen Crow has got to run the ball on West Monroe, keep the ball away from West Monroe's clock. They control the clock with their O-line.
Yeah.
That's the key. You have to run the ball on West Monroe. And I'm just thinking that West Monroe, they put 9 in the box, and they look like a college. And they look bigger than Acadiana, who's been the only team to give Karen Crow trouble this past year. So, you know, it's hard to – I'm not pulling for either team. I'm just predicting West Monroe.
All right. Well, appreciate it. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. And look, to go with the other classifications – I'm going to pick St. Charles Catholic again in 3A. A-meet, Alden Foster's done a great job. His quarterback's improved, Coach. He's a better passer this year. They got a linebacker named Jerwan Rogers, the only other linebacker in the state, not committed yet to me, that's SEC, besides your linebacker, Lorenzo Phillips, who's going to be on later tonight. But A-meet's got the best back four in the secondary besides yours in the state. But we're going to talk about the other classifications. 4A, Coach, I predicted Neville to beat Bro Bridge. I thought Bro Bridge had a great team. I was just taking them because Neville's O&D line is a little bit better. And their quarterback is a phenomenal player running that option slash.
I watched that football game Friday night, and I thought John Dios from Neville was definitely the difference in the game. He had safety. He had two interceptions. He did a great job at quarterback, and he's just a junior. I think he might be one of the top two or three players in the state next year, definitely.
He's deceptively fast, as you would agree. He's tall and he's big, but not fat. He's just a deceptively fat. He picks his cuts, and he's hard to stop. And that big O-line they have, not overly bearing O-line, but just a big line. We're going to talk about the other classifications when we come back with Coach, then take Mickey McCarty's call. Speaking of Neville, he'll be calling in from Neville High School. He's in the Dome in 4A, and they have a tough opponent as well in 4A, Edna Carr of New Orleans, who's loaded with players. We'll talk about them also when we come back.
Opportunity here to tell you why you need to check out ITI Technical College. You can get your technical drafting degree in less than 2 years. You get specialized technical training, work in areas like architecture, manufacturing, construction, or engineering. Get hands-on training, skills for a competitive edge, flexible class schedules, and financial aid is available.
Hi, I'm Joe Martin, president of ITI Technical College. Listen to Opportunity. Call ITI now or go online. It's that simple. We're your key to a better life.
At ITI, Opportunity doesn't just knock, it rocks.
At Peak Performance Physical Therapy, we treat everyone from Grand Slam hitters to grandparents. Now with 7 locations to serve you. If your doctor recommends physical therapy, ask for Peak Performance by name. The physical therapy choice of baseball players, grandparents, and everyone in between.
Arrive to the game in style in a new or certified Peretti family vehicle.
Jaguar, with timeless elegance, is the sportiest, sexiest luxury automobile on the road. Land Rover is rough enough for all your hunting needs, yet refined enough to deserve valet parking. Mazda will connect you with your inner driver at a whole new level of intensity.
Remember, it's not whether you win or lose, it's how you get to the game. Peretti, Jaguar, Land Rover, Mazda, Baton Rouge, New Orleans.
Louisiana Office Supply is the largest stocking office product store in the South with a new 23,000 square foot showroom. For over 72 years, Louisiana Office Supply has met the demand for quality office products competitively priced with an extensive selection and knowledgeable staff. From office furniture to Post-it notes, there are supplies for every part of your office. Louisiana Office Supply, generation after generation, exceptional service since 1936.
If you're looking for the gear you need in the colors you bleed, then make your first stop Co-op. Much more than just a bookstore, Co-op has the largest selection of LSU merchandise for the whole family, including tailgating supplies, LSU clothing and accessories, great gifts, and a whole lot more. Stop in or order online for the best prices on art supplies, school supplies, and textbooks. The Co-op Bookstore, where you'll always find the gear you need in the colors you bleed.
Before we go to Mickey McCarty, the head coach at Neville, I want to talk to Coach Minton about the other classifications in the Superdome, the State Farm Superdome Championships this weekend in the Superdome. Mercedes-Benz Superdome. I've got to get used to saying that. All right. We want to talk about Neville. I'm going to take Neville over Edna Carr. Jabbar Jaluk, phenomenal job. It's his consecutive trip to the Dome. They lost in late last year in the state championship. Edna Carr, it's going to be a great game in Neville. John Curtis, Winfield. Winfield's got some players. They got Trey Gilbert at running back, Alonzo Moore, top receiver in the state. Winfield will give Curtis a game, but I think it's going to be Curtis. Wichita Christian, West St. John. West St. John's got a ton of speed. They do play a lot of kids on offense and defense, the same kids. Wichita Christian has 30 kids just in their senior class and 120 dress that'll play, so that'll be the difference. A-Meet, St. Charles, I'm going with St. Charles like Coach, and West Monroe in 5A. I have four of my predictions left from a month ago out of five. And I was hoping Coach would be there, though. I picked him. He was my fifth pick in 3A. But let's go ahead and Mickey McCarty's not on the lines yet. We'll get him in a few moments, hopefully. And I want to talk more about this Winfield game, Coach, in 2A. John Curtis, you know, Some games it seems they get the right team that they can't compete, and then some championship games they'll get O.P. Walker that can beat them.
Yeah.
And Winfield, I think, is one of those teams.
I think Winfield has some skilled people that's going to give Curtis some problems, but I feel like Curtis has been a team on a mission all year. You know, they lost two straight to Evangel in the Dome. You saw last week that they were sitting in wait for Evangel this year. And
yeah.
And I don't think J.T. Kerr is too good a football coach. I don't think he's going to let Winfield slip up on them and take away what they've been working for all year.
I agree. I think John Curtis is going to win, but I think it'll be competitive. Winfield has more talent than you would think. If you saw him play like I have three times this year, I mean, they are big on the O-line. Their defensive end coach is 6'4", 230, runs a 4'5", junior. And their receiver, Alonzo Moore, looks like a thin version of Reuben Randall. And Trey Gilbert reminds me of your kid, Stewart, who's committed to Houston. Yeah. So the weapons are there to be successful. But I'm like you, Curtis is a team will win that game. And then in 1A, West St. John. Robert Valdez doing a great job.
He's done a great job over there. We played West St. John in 7-on-7 a couple times this summer, and we knew he had a good ball club. And I think what you said earlier, that could be the determining factor in that game is the depth Wichita Christian has. And West St. John's playing quite a few kids both ways. But I got to admit, I'm going to be pulling for Coach Valdez. Me and him are good friends, and I hope he can go down there and take it.
I'm friends with both coaches, Fitzhugh from Wichita Christian. Plays two quarterbacks. To me, that's going to be the difference. The starting quarterback is also the starting strong safety. When he's at strong safety, Sol Graves, the former LSU quarterback from the 80s, his son Quinn Graves goes in as a dropback quarterback when the other quarterback, Bristow, goes to safety. And they both run 4-6. So they can change it up. If one plan's not working, they use another one. They have a fullback that's pretty good. It's about 2'10", 5'10", that's a junior. And that big Tarver kid we showed tonight is the offensive tackle, and they got a tight end at 6'4", 250, runs a 4'8". and they got a receiver that's All-State three times.
Mark Laird, yes.
Mark Laird's got over, get this, 5,000 career yards in high school receiving and 65 touchdowns and 32 interceptions on defense.
Good body of work there.
So, I mean, yeah, it's going to be, all these are great games. Coach McCarty hasn't called in yet, but Tommy, talk about some of your players. We've got two of you kids coming up next segment, but talk about Trevon Stewart that's committed to Houston, your running back, and some of your other seniors that are probably going to sign this year.
Well, we've been very blessed with skilled people the last few years, and if you look at what's being recruited on my team this year, Jedrick DeCluitt, my starting wide receiver, is committed to Houston, along with Trevon Stewart, who played running back and defensive back for me. My outside linebacker, Lorenzo Phillips, was committed to Florida for a long time. He's since decommitted and is being considering Texas A&M, LSU, Florida, a couple other schools. And
he's going to come on later.
He's going to come on later. And my middle linebacker, Tremaine Lightfoot, has offers from ULL, Louisiana Tech, Houston, and McNeese, and is in the process of trying to figure out what he wants to do. And my quarterback also has several offers from the Division I AA schools around the state. So it's been a good year for us as far as being able to get some kids some recruiting attention, and it's going to carry over to next year with our young guys, hopefully.
I want to mention this. I didn't tell you this off the air, Coach, but I watched every high school in the state. 20 years ago, I'd ask you for film. I didn't have cameras, but the last 10 years, we have 14 cameras. I have 14 filmers, and we film everybody three times in the state. I just give it to colleges to help the kids. But Trevon Stewart, I had as one of the top five running backs in the state after watching all the teams, not just Lafayette and Baton Rouge, all of them in the state. Lightfoot was my third best middle linebacker in the state, all right, in the whole state, okay? Lorenzo Phillips in the top two as an outside backer. Your receiver that's going to come on later from Houston, that's committed to Houston, he's in the top five as an athlete. You've got five kids in the top five at every position from looking at all the teams that I saw this year.
Well, I felt like those guys were going to be good players for us this year. They all started for us last year on a team that went to the Dome. And, you know, one of the key areas that we were very young at this year was on the offensive line. We started three sophomores on the offensive line. We had a couple of freshmen that played a lot on the D-line, and that was the areas where, you know, we matured as the year went on, but we knew playing some of these teams down the line in the playoffs, like your St. Charles, your Parkviews, your Notre Dames, that area might be exposed because of our youth, and sure enough, against St. Charles, it was.
But you lost Kenny Hilliard from last year. Let's not make that. I mean, that's a huge loss. Well, you still had a great, successful season, and you had to replace him.
Well, but you said it. I mean, if Trevon would have been behind Kenny Hilliard the last 2 years, he'd have been a 1,500-yard rusher each year. Trevon did a great job of stepping in at running back and doing the things we needed him to do there for us to have a rushing attack. So.
Well, Coach, stay here. We're going to keep you on the set. You're going to finish the show with your two recruits. We're going to have you come back, Coach Tommy Minton, the head coach at Patterson High School. We're going to bring his two recruits on. He's got other recruits, but these are two of his top seniors that one's committed to Houston and one is uncommitted. And LSU's recruiting this kid, too. We'll be back in just a moment.
State Farm agents Brian Moe and Joan Meir in Baton Rouge are there for you. Call today.
If you're looking for the gear you need in the colors you bleed, then make your first stop Co-op. Much more than just a bookstore, Co-op has the largest selection of LSU merchandise for the whole family, including tailgating supplies, LSU clothing and accessories, great gifts, and a whole lot more. Stop in or order online for the best prices on art supplies, school supplies, and textbooks. The Co-op Bookstore, where you'll always find the gear you need in the colors you bleed.
Have you made the right call?
I made the right call.
It's easy to do. Just touch the tones.
I made the right call.
If you want to talk to the pros, you've got to make the right call.
I made the right call.
It's not that kind of call. I'm talking about the professionals at Gage Telephone. From excellent products like Toshiba to great service after the sale, make the right call. Gage Telephone, 753-4243.
Hi, I'm Joe Martin, president of ITI Technical College. And for over 35 years, ITI has been a leader in technical education here in Baton Rouge.
ITI's medical division offers hands-on training in three new medical programs: medical billing and coding, medical management, and medical assistant. ITI offers flexible class schedules, and financial aid is available.
So let ITI help you discover a better life. Call now or go online. It's that simple.
ITI for a better life.
At Peak Performance Physical Therapy, we treat everyone from three-point shooters to three-piece suits, now with seven locations to serve you. If your doctor recommends physical therapy, ask for Peak Performance by name, the physical therapy choice of basketball players, businessmen, and everyone in between.
Check out our website, LAFootballMagazine.com. Those are the Barnes & Nobles that you can pick a copy up. And you can go to our .com store if you want to just go ahead and order it. Hey, it's a good Christmas gift. We're almost out of issues, actually. We've got a couple of hundred issues left from this past season to get to the parents that probably didn't know that it was out there. But we want to go ahead and I want to introduce, we've got Coach Tommy Minton from Patterson, the head coach, but he's joined by two of his recruits, not all of his recruits, but two, Jadrick DeCluett. Right?
Yes, sir.
All right. A receiver slash athlete committed to the University of Houston. Right?
Yes, sir.
Lorenzo Phillips, yeah. Uncommitted linebacker, yes, was sir. Committed to
Florida
Gators. Mm-hmm. And now, Tommy, your take on your two kids before I start talking to your recruits here. Talk about Lorenzo and DeCluett.
Well, Jadrick has played wide receiver, been a 3-year starter for us. And he was what we call our X receiver. We used him, isolated him a lot on the backside of our 3-by-1 formations to try to get one-on-one coverage with him, and we used him also in the slot some. I think he's going to be a slot receiver in college. That's what most Houston is viewing him as. And he's got great hands, he's got great speed, and I think he's going to have a big career in that pass-happy offense over there that Houston runs.
Sign another Keenum, right, to throw to you, right?
Yes,
Case, what do you think of Case Keenum, by the way?
Oh, he's great. Great athlete, good quarterback.
They had 4 slot receivers that were seniors this year, and none of them were really bigger than you. I mean, they were all about 5'9", 10".
Yeah. That was one of the big things that factored into his decision was the fact that they had a ton of senior receivers, and they need some guys to step up and give them some depth right away next year.
That's a slot. Conference USA ought to be called the slot league, because SMU slot, Tulsa slot, all of them use the slot receivers. But Lorenzo, you're uncommitted.
Yep.
You got LSU fans watching.
Right.
They're recruiting you. Mm-hmm. Is Chavis recruiting you, or the whole defensive staff recruiting?
I talked to Coach Frank every now and then. Yeah, Coach Frank Wilson. And they coming by the house tomorrow night or whatever, and they talk to me, they keep in touch with me and make sure everything's still good.
So they're trying to put the full court press on you tomorrow night?
They're not pressuring me into nothing at all. They tell me, they with me with me taking my time and everything.
But you're wide open.
Oh, yeah.
You told me you don't even have a top anything.
I'm gonna just wait until signing day, and I'm gonna make my decision from there. I'm gonna take my officials and everything. So
committing early, like you said, might have been too early. You could.
Yeah, I think so. With my mom and everything going up there, and they were telling me how much they love it and everything, I just kind of made me wanna. That's what I wanted to be, But once I got home and everything, I started thinking about it, and I wasn't ready for that yet.
Now, I want to get back to the slot receiver here. You're watching any of the bowl games coming up besides Houston Cougars? Are you loving all the BCS games that are coming up? Anything that sticks out to you?
Oh, yes, sir. I'm going to be watching the LSU and Alabama game.
And what is your thoughts on Alabama, Trent Richardson, and what do you think of Tyrann Mathieu?
He's my favorite player in college football.
And Lorenzo, I mean, what is there a particular game you're going to be watching?
Oh, yeah, the same game.
LSU-Alabama.
Oh, yeah, no doubt.
Now, I mean, y'all were in high school. Y'all watch a lot of football games, right?
Yeah.
Who do you pick in that game, Alabama, LSU?
I think it's going to be a good game, but
I'm going to go for LSU.
I think LSU going to put a win, you know. They kicker, you know, Alabama's kicker, he missed the field goals to, you know, the guy could have put him up in the game early and everything. But I think LSU's kicker pretty dependable now, and you know he's been. Oh yeah,
he's from where? Lafayette area.
Oh, yeah.
Drew Alamont.
Yep.
So. And the punter from Alabama, Cody Mandel, is from Acadiana High School in Lafayette. Isn't that amazing,
yeah,
Coach
Minton?
I mean, what do you think of that game? I mean, Kenny Hilliard's in it.
I mean,
teammate either.
Right.
I'm an LSU fan. I'm from South Louisiana, and I'm rooting for LSU. I got two kids, Kenny Hilliard. Played for us, and also the deep snapper, special teams captain, Joey Propel, is one of our ex-Patterson Lumberjacks. So, I'm definitely rooting for LSU. I think it's going to be a little bit higher scoring game than what the last one was. I think LSU is going to play a lot better offensively than what they played in the first game.
And one of your guys is going to be a key in that, Kenny Hilliard.
I hope so.
Now, I got to ask you this. Since you're a coach, and I'm watching film, and I'm thinking, what changes the philosophy of this game? Alabama, they know Trent Richardson, that's the bread and butter, and Marcus Mays, mm-hmm. they're slot guy, and they're tight ends. And then LSU rotates those four running backs, one of them being Kenny. But do you think anything will change?
I think the biggest thing that's going to change from the first game is the fact that Jordan Jefferson started the last four or five games. He's got that much more experience, and the best games Jefferson's played in his LSU career have been bowl games, when he's had 4 to 5 weeks to prepare and have a game plan for that long. He's exploded in the bowl games against Texas A&M and against Georgia Tech. So I think he might be the thing that makes us score a little bit higher scoring.
Plus this year LSU is 2-0 on turf in Dallas Stadium. They look faster when they played Oregon. They look pretty fast against Georgia. And I think Matthew's going to have another big game, because on turf, I think he is a lot faster and makes bigger plays. And I think Reuben Randall will be a part of that. You know, Reuben.
The LSU team as a whole.
Yeah.
It's such great team speed, offensively and defensively, and that turf just magnifies that.
Yeah. The rematch, huh? They're talking about Muhammad Ali and Joe Frazier, right? I mean, it's the football game of the boxing world. But Lorenzo, talk about real quick before we run out of time, who is your favorite opponent to play every year at Patterson?
Every year?
Or the team you like playing the most?
This year was my favorite team to play against was Franklin.
Okay.
Because then we had an old coach that went there. He's Jay Arna.
Okay.
And we also had a linebacker coach that went there. And he went with him or whatever, and it's just been a whole big old thing.
Bragging rights.
Yeah. So
Jay played for the University of Miami Hurricanes.
Yeah,
I remember.
Yeah.
Jay was my offensive line coach for 4 years, and then he went to took the job.
Jadrick, who did you like to play the most?
Well, this year I like to play the most with Brule, our first round game in the playoffs, and I had a good game that season. That was the best game of my season this year.
Guys, I've got gift certificate for you, Coach, at Superior Grill, and T-shirts for everybody. Guys, I appreciate you coming on the show. Watch the replay tonight at 10:30. Coach Manton, I appreciate you. Guys, good luck to your future.
Thank you.
All right? And to the Lumberjacks, several players will sign this year. Watch the show next Tuesday. We'll talk about the wins and losses in the Superdome on Louisiana Football TV Magazine.